Southwood foul number 21, Amy Bowman.
Quarter, and King Stasiak to shoot two. First one for Stasiak, good. Rochester up 1-0. They do look a lot alike, Bob Bresch.
Who?
Falco and Stasiak. Okay. Second one by Stasiak is good. And the rebound to Stauffer. Heat. Right side to Elliott at the free throw line. Picks up her dribble, gives to Heath high on the right side. Now she drives the paint outside to Houlihan. Back to Heath, to Houlihan at the elbow left, and she travels. Rochester going to get it back up 1-0. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 6.5 to play first quarter. Rochester up 1-0 and have the basketball going to our left. Murph walks it up the floor. Man-to-man defense by the Southwood Lady Knights. She works against Elliott, works left wing at the elbow in the paint. Has her pass kicked away and picked up by Heath. Heath runs for Southwood to our right. Bounce pass right side to Bowman. Bowman behind the arc, back to Heath, top of the key. He has a couple of dribbles, now at the elbow. Drives it right, pulls it back outside to Houlihan. Her jumper from the free throw line, no good. Rebound to Elliott, her putback is no good. Ball being kicked around, Paula comes out of there with it. And B clears the X.
Lady Knights having a hard time getting the lid off the basket.
And those shots are point blank.
They are.
Holland in the paint, goes to the basket, throws up a shot, no good. And the rebound comes down to Southwood. And Bowman, who gives the head to Heath. 1-0 Rochester, 5:45 to play in the first quarter. Heath drives it deep to the right, now brings it top of the key to Bowman, and we're going to have a foul on Becky Malco, I believe, who is shadowing Bowman.
That'll be her first, team second.
Southwood basketball out of bounds, baseline left, as Heath will look to get it in.
Bowman hasn't really had too many touches here.
Yeah, you're right, about two maybe.
Yeah.
Stauffer in the left corner of the baseline, gives top of the key to Houlihan, now to Elliott. Fakes, drives it right, picks up her dribble, looking for Stauffer down low, has her against a double team. She has the ball stripped away. Bowman there to pick it up. Her shot no good. Her shot partially blocked. And now we're going to have a tie-up down low, and it's going to go to Rochester on the defensive rebound.
Nice job by Malco and Stasiak, tipping the ball away and keeping it alive, and finally coming with the tie-up.
Stauffer, three or four opportunities here within 5 feet in already in this quarter. 5:20 to play, first quarter. 1-0 Rochester. Pollock at the free throw line. Back to Malco. Malco drives right. Goes right to Stauffer. Her shot partially blocked. She comes down as she got hit in the eye. No call. And then the rebound. And the pass is stolen away from behind by Murphy. Murphy coming the other way. Picks up her dribble. Gets the head of Stasiak. Keaton. Baseline to Malco. Jumper. No good. Rebound tipped around. Stauffer comes out of there with it for Southwood. Stauffer now ahead to Elliott. Elliott left side of the floor. She loses the handle and she throws it away into the hands of Holland. That's Holland. Left-handed layup. No good. Keaton rebound. And on this shot, Stauffer is going to be called for a foul, I believe, and that's going to send Alexa Holland to the line to shoot two. And Stauffer will pick up her first team third. These guys are getting chewed on by both benches, and we're 4:46 into the game. Wow. So X at the line. 4-2, first one for the sophomores, in and out, no good. She'll have one more. 1-0 Rochester, 4:45 to play in the first quarter. Alexa had 28 at Culver.
25.
25 at Culver.
Yeah.
Okay. Second for the sophomores, good. 2-0 Rochester.
Something like 11 of 13 free throws.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Best shot from about that good from behind the arc as well. Left side to Bowman. Bowman high on the left side, top to Heath. Stands right between the circles at the volleyball line. Now back to Bowman. She drives the baseline. Tries the up and under. It goes, and we're tied at two. That's a good shot. Her body, her entire body was under the backboard, and with the right hand, brought it up and under and put it in. Wrap around pass to Pollock. Be over Stauffer. No good. And the rebound tipped around, and Heath comes out of there with it for the Lady Knights. Southwood runs to our right. Fills the middle of the floor. Now drives it right. Gives to Houlihan. Her jumper from inside the arc is good, and Southwood leads 4-2. 4 minutes of play in the first quarter. Malco with the basketball, runs the point against the man-to-man defense. Out of Holland, who's being shadowed by Heath. Drives to the elbow, out to Malco. She's in the lane, stops, pops, too hard, no good. And Houlihan with the rebound for Southwood, and now we're going to have an official timeout as Stauffer needs to tie her shoe. 3:47 to play in the first quarter, 4-2 Southwood. It'll be Lady Knight basketball.
Lady Knight's doing a much better job of owning the rebounds at each end of the floor, both offensive and defensively, and Lady Zebras losing opportunities to score.
Yeah, you're right. One and done right now for Rochester.
Yeah.
Stauffer throws it out of bounds, and Rochester's going to get it back. And this game probably really should be about 10 or 12 to 2.
Yeah.
As many point-blank shots as Southwood's had already in this quarter.
Well, but you've noticed the last two trips down the floor, excluding the turnovers, they're on the last trip, they are starting to dial it in.
Yeah.
And that could be
right.
Scary thought,
as
open as some of them shots have been.
Malcolm at the elbow, feeds down low to Stasiak. Her jumper is partially blocked by Bowman and picked up by Heath. Had Bowman on her hip and couldn't finish. Heath through the center circle for Southwood. 3:20 to play in the first quarter, 4-2, Lady Knight. Heath top of the key. Feeds to Stauffer at the elbow. Outside to Houlihan. She drives the paint. Jumper over B. Pollock is no good. Offensive rebound to Elliott. Her putback is blocked. Offensive rebound again by Elliott. Putback is good. Well, you can tell why the freshman's starting. She had three opportunities there. Now Rochester will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Well, we're still catching every game, just a lot more from home than here in the stands, huh?
Yeah, and when we do get to go, Dad says we got to bring our own peanuts and stuff.
Looking for some extra ticket money this season? Let a State Farm agent do a free discount double check that could save you hundreds of dollars on car insurance.
We'll always be there for this team, even when we can't actually be here.
Get started by contacting State Farm agent Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017.
State Farm is there. Discounts may vary state to state.
Zebra basketball, WROI.
2:59 to play in the first quarter. Southwood out to a 6-2 lead, and after the Rochester timeout, they'll have the basketball underneath the Southwood basket going the entire length of the floor. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman.
Lady Zebras having to exert an extraneous amount of effort on both ends of the floor. One, defensively to keep the Lady Knights off the glass, and two, offensively just trying to find an opening.
And they're not doing that very well, keeping them off the glass. Pollock, jumper's no good. Elliott with the rebound. Southwood allowing Rochester, or not allowing Rochester any more than just one shot. Back door to Elliott.
While at the same time getting multiple shots at the other end.
Yeah, you're right. Elliott drives baseline, a lot of contact, throws up a shot, no good. And then Pollock grabs the board and gives to Holland. 6-2, Southwood, 2:25 to play in the first quarter.
Ready.
X, crossover dribble at the free throw line, steps back and drives out to Malco. Malco in the paint, stops, rises up, shots good, and a foul.
From number 20, Becky Malco.
So Becky Malco will go to the line to shoot one free throw.
Well, it'll be Houlihan second.
And coming into the game quickly is Emily Harnish, a 5'7 sophomore, and Houlihan to sit down.
Emily Harnish.
So Malco with one free throw, looking to cut this lead to one. The sophomore eyes the first one, flies it. Missed it. Stauffer the rebound, now to Bowman. Bowman pushes to our right. Right side to Heath. And she loses the basketball. Holland picks it up. Rochester runs. Two on the one break. Stasiak, leaner on the way. Her shot's no good. Rebound to Harnish. Harnish for Stoughton now picks up her dribble and gives the head to Heath. Heath travels.
It's going to be a physical ball game, I feel.
Yeah. One end of the floor, Southwood Knights fans are chewing on the officials. The other end of the floor on the same, basically, possession, the Rochester fans are chewing on it. Oh, boy.
Everybody's screaming about the contact.
Yeah. So. 6-4 Southwood, a minute 45 to play in the first quarter. B against Stomper, layup, good, and we're tied at 6. And that's what Coach Stasiak's been saying all day. So far, that shot is there, just take it to her.
Gotta take it.
Heath has her pass intercepted by Stasiak. Heath picks up, gives to Malco. Rochester runs to our left, tied at 6, a minute 25 to play first quarter. Malco drives it right behind the arc, down low, her pass is taken away by Bowman. Boy, how quick was Amy Bowman to pick up on what Rochester wanted to do there?
Stepping right in the passing lane.
Ball still loose on the floor. Bowman picks it up, gives it to Heath. It's a minute 10 to Stoffer at the elbow. Stoffer against Murphy. Back outside to Heath. Top two, a wide open Harnish. She'll fire a three for Southwood. It's good. 9-6 Southwood, under a minute to play in the first quarter.
Holland doing a great job of shadowing Holland, not letting her escape at all.
Holland for three. Good, and we're tied at 9. Heath runs the other way with 42. Right side to Harnish. To Stoffer. Her pass looking back door to Elliott is knocked out of bounds. And it'll be Southwood basketball. Baseline left, 40 seconds to play. First quarter, we're tied at 9. Haley Heath will trigger it in. Baseline left. Looking. Still looking. Over the top of the defense to Harnish. Down to Stoffer in the lane. Turnaround jumper 10 feet away is good. That's a good-looking shot.
That is a good-looking shot. She didn't hesitate at all. Just turned around and put it up.
11-9. Southwood, 27 seconds to play in the opening quarter. And more than likely, Coach Stasiak looking for the final shot of the period. X down the left wing. Holland outside to Malco with 20. Becky Malco in the paint. Rises up. Throws up a shot. It's off the window and good. We're tied at 11. 12 seconds to play first quarter. Heath with 9. Heath gets the Stoffer. Has her pass knocked out of bounds by Stasiak with 6 seconds to play in the first quarter. We're tied at 11. Heath baseline right. We'll look to get it in. Heath slaps the basketball, sends things in motion, studies, got to get it in over the defense to Stauffer with 4. Stauffer's 18-footer is no good. The rebound put back at the buzzer by Harnish is no good. After 1, we're tied at 11. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
How's the water in your home? Uh-oh, you're still doing things the hard way with hard water? Scrubbing soap scum and scale off everything, plus all that extra soap and moisturizer for your dry skin. And let's not forget the spotty dishes and scratchy, dull laundry. What a mess. Take it from me. Save yourself a lot of trouble and money by having your Culligan man test your water. Right now, you can try a Culligan softening or drinking water system for only $20 a month. Call 574-223-2420. That's 574-223-2420. Or go to CulliganFultonCounty.com. Just say, hey, Culligan man. Culligan, better water, pure and simple. See dealer for details. Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Plymouth wants you to enjoy your world. And now the basketball, swimming, and wrestling are back. And college and pro football continue. There's plenty to do. So whether it's heading for the gym, holiday open houses, and getting together with friends and family, grab the refreshingly clean taste of Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, Sprite, and Sprite Zero. Make sure you have plenty of Coca-Cola products on hand, either from the store or the vending machine. Coca-Cola products go great with everything you do. It's the real thing. It's Coca-Cola.
Basketball, WROI. Second quarter we go at Rochester High School. We're tied at 11, and Southwood will start the second period of the basketball. Rochester, Brad, lucky to be as close as tied at 11.
Yeah, they're lucky to have it tied up.
Yeah. So
Southwood's really been doing a great job of getting second shot opportunities on offense and limiting Rochester's chances on offense.
Bowman dribbles around the defense, but gives it to Stoffer, and that's exactly what you talked about. As Bowman drives and dumps it down to wide open Stoffer, she puts the Southwood Lady Knights back up by 2 at 13-11. Murph down low to wide open Stasiak. Keaton gives to Pollock. Jumper is good. We're tied at 13. Nice job by Keaton Stasiak. Threw Stoffer away from Pollock, and B finished with an easy wide open shot.
Works the opposite side of the lane.
Bowman over Pollock. Short. Rebound. those to are, Southwood and Harnish.
Yeah, those are rebounds the Lady Zebras have got to come up with.
Right.
They had the numbers out, you know, 3-1 under the basket when the shot was taken, and they did not get the rebound.
No, it was a loose ball rebound to Harnish, and then she traveled, so Rochester are going to get it back. 13-13. Rochester, the basketball going to our left. Excellent left wing. Holland fakes left, drives right, gives to Malco. She's in the paint, throws up a shot off the glass, foul on the shoot, on the shot, I should say, and she'll go to the free throw line to shoot two for Rochester. Oh, before the shot, I beg your pardon.
All right, comes on Bowman, her second. So Bowman and Houlihan both with two.
7:06 to play, first half, we're tied at 13. Holland looks to get it in over the defense to Malco, high on the right side. Becky, back to Holland. Out of Malco, top of the key, 2-3 zone by the Lady Knights to Malco. To Murphy, 4-3, left wing, good!
That's where Carly Murphy can be dangerous. They've got Holland tied up pretty well in the opposite corner. Carly Murphy can start hitting those open threes.
Rochester up 16-13. Heath to Harnish, fakes the three at the elbow to Harnish, just inside the three-point line, jumper short. Another offensive rebound by Southwood, and then Stasiak tips the basketball out of bounds. It'll stay with Southwood on the far side.
Lady Knights are really active. You got Stauffer at 6'2 in the middle, and she takes up a large portion of the middle of that floor, and the rest of the Lady Knights fill in the holes. They do a good job of covering the rebounds.
Stauffer at the elbow, throws it to Coach Stasiak. And Rochester going to get it back up by three.
Now, turnovers are quickly becoming a factor in this basketball game for the Lady Knights.
So Randall's keeping stats on the bench, and I just asked him what the offensive rebounding was right now for Southwood. They've got nine offensive boards.
Wow.
We're 6:24 to play in the second quarter. Wow. Pollock at the free throw line. Drives left against Stauffer. Pull-up jumper on the way is short. And the rebound to Elliott. 16-13 Rochester. Elliott and Southwood runs left. Got a Harnish to Stauffer, cutting to a wide open Bowman. She throws a shot up and it's good.
Bowman to Stauffer, Stauffer to Bowman.
You know, we saw a lot of that last night as the tallest guy on the floor for Plymouth was 6'9", and he'd hold the ball above his head and have a great look at it. And then Pollock's shot is blocked. She gets it back, kicks it out to Murphy, fakes a three, drives it right, throws up a shot. She's fouled on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two. I guess to finish that thought, when you're 6'2", and you're taller than everybody else by 6 inches on the floor, you do have a great look at everything on the floor.
Yeah, you're right. Especially when you practice all week long on the backdoor cuts. A lot of times you don't have to see them. You just know they're going to be there.
Murphy's first free throw, no good. And for the first time this year, Bailey Abbott comes into the game, the 5'8 junior. She started a little late. She's come on now and replaced Keaton Stasiak. Free throw by Murphy. No good. Too hard. Stop for the board. 16-15 Rochester. 5:45 to play in the first half. Here comes a run and jump defense. And Harnish got away with the travel, then throws it out of bounds. And Rochester going to get it back. So Alexa Garrison, the 5'10 freshman and the 5'9 freshman, comes in, and Murphy to sit. 5:38 to play in the first half. 16-15 Rochester, and they've got the basketball going to our left.
Triangle.
And I think triangle for Coach Stasiak means we're going to run some clock here.
Yeah.
Bailey, trying to Pollock. B against Stauffer in the double team. Out to Malco. Drives it right. Has her shot blocked. Elliott picks it up and runs to our right for Southwood. Elliott, middle of the floor. Right side to Bowman. Back to Elliott on the right elbow to Bowman. She'll take the 15-footer right side as good as it bangs in. And now Southwood back up.
6 for Bowman.
Two fouls.
You're right.
17-16 Southwood. 5 minutes to play, first half. Malco forces a pass to Abbott. Kicks it out to X. Holland with Heath in her face. Throws up a teardrop shot. No good. And Abbott with the rebound, and then she is fouled. And
nope,
tied up. And Southwood will keep possession. I'm sorry, Rochester will keep possession.
Four. Bailey's wide out.
Holland will trigger it in. Over the defense of Pollock. B against the double team. Foul on the shot. Sugar to the line to shoot two. And that's going to be on Stauffer. That'll be number four, two on Stauffer, I believe.
Number 40,
right.
Katie Stauffer.
And so after the first free throw, Murphy and Stasiak will check back into the game.
And the Lady Zebras will be in the bonus the rest of this half.
Yeah.
I just say straight up, Katie.
Be ready. Let the first one go. Good. tied at 17. Stasiak in the game, and Murphy will replace B. Pollock if she makes this one. Miranda Friend, a 5'4 junior in the game for the first time, is sitting down as Heat. 4:45 to play in the first half, 17-17, and Pollock for Rochester with one more freebie. The second one, no good. Stauffer the rebound to Bowman. Southwood pushes. We're tied at 17. Bowman right side of the floor. Over the top of the defense to Friend. To Stauffer. To Bowman. To Harnish. Harnish one dribble to Stauffer in the lane. Against the double team. She's fouled the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
Super foul. Number 22.
The foul coming against Pollock. That's her second.
Southwood shooting two.
So Katie Stauffer, the 6'2 sophomore, with the line to shoot two for Southwood. Again, we're deadlocked at 17. The first one of the way for the junior is good. And she'll have one more. Murphy back in. Pollock to sit. Also back in for Southwood is Houlihan and Elliott to come out. Stauffer and Southwood with one more free throw with 4.5 minutes to play in the first half. Stauffer's second one. Good again. 19-17. Southwood back on top of two. I believe Southwood's had a four-point lead, the biggest lead of the game for them. Rochester's biggest lead has been three, so it's been back and forth, obviously, the first half. Stasiak around the defense. Now to Murphy, to Holland. Lob pass to Abbott. Bailey on the block. Shot against Stauffer. It's partially blocked, and Stauffer the rebound. Now to Bowman. Bowman has her pass tipped away. Bailey Abbott with the rebound. Gives the head to Holland. And then X has her pocket first kick from behind by Bowman. Now quickly to Friend. Friend running the other way. Pass tipped away. Stasiak with the basketball. Rochester running to our left. Now Stasiak is ran over by Garrison. And Stasiak still down. Stasiak gets up. She was hit hard. She and Garrison hit hard.
Yeah, I think
they were... Yeah.
When you get bumped in the nose, it really make your eyes water.
So Malco back into the game, and Stasiak will sit down. 19-17 Southwood, 3:55 to play in the first half. It'll be nice basketball. Stauffer wide open. Jump is good.
Well, I believe the Zebras are just, they just look a little bit frazzled and wore out.
Holland. Goes in the lane hard. Foul of the shot. She'll go to the lane to shoot two. And Danielle Pegg, a 5'9 sophomore, will come into the game for the first time for Southwood after the first free throw by Holland.
Shooting Heath will pick up her first.
A3 on the fouls, and they're doing the trapping. Got it?
Free throw is good by Holland. She'll have one more. And Stauffer comes out of the game. And again, back in or in for the first time is Pegg. Holland with one more. Looking to cut this lead to two. Second one is good again by X. Full court press by Rochester. Houlihan just about turned it over to Harnish. Harnish beats ahead to Heath. And they cross the timeline to Friend. Friend has her pass tipped away by Malco out of bounds. It'll stay with, nope, they're going to stay last touch by Southwood. I beg your pardon. 3:29 to play in the first half. Rochester down by two. At 21-19, I thought it was off of Malco.
The only thing I think maybe he was thinking that her foot was on the line when she was bobbling the ball before Malco tipped it out.
Bowman back into the game for Southwood. 3:25 to play in the first half. 21-19 Rochester. Malco the basketball against the man-to-man defense. Malco works to the left side. Feeds down low to stay to Abbott. Abbott puts up a shot. It's no good. The rebound to Pegg, who gives it ahead to Bowman. Bowman ahead to Carnish. To Pegg. Right-handed layup. No good. The offensive putback is no good. And Holland comes out of there with it. X runs through the floor. X loses the basketball to Harnish. She loses the basketball, but right into the hands of Heath, and Southwood with the basketball up by two. Good heavens. And then Holland just is fouled on the reach in.
That'll be her first.
Alexa Holland picks up a foul. With 2:49 to play in the first half, Southwood up 21-19. Stasiak back in, and Garrison to sit.
Back in the senior lineup, number 12, Keith Stasiak.
Bowman will look to get it in right in front of the Rochester bench. And Heath delivers a shoulder right into the lip of Holland. Heath drives it right, drives it to the block, and she's going to be caught for charge.
So Heath will pick up her second.
To play the first half, 21-19, Southwood, and Lady Knights will bring Friend back in, also Elliott, and he comes out, also Harnish will come out. Malco will bring it up, down by two.
We're going to have to put ropes up around the square.
Yeah, and hold back all 35 people in the gym.
It's like a boxing match, ringside seat.
Murphy, cross court left to wide open. Holland for three, no good. A lot of contact, and we're going to have
hit the wire.
Yeah. Hit the cable. So Southwood will get it back up by two, 2:25 to play in the first half. Friend has it, now to Elliott. Elliott against Holland, drives it left, picks up her dribble, gives to Friend. Friend now middle of the floor will set up the offense for Southwood. Drives it right. We're going to have an offensive foul and Peg as she ran over at it. And Rochester going to get it back.
And Peg will pick up her first.
2:16 to play in the first half. Rochester down 21-19. And Lady Zebras will have the basketball. And Becky Malco will run the point for Rochester as she'll walk it through the center circle against the man-to-man defense. Our 2-3 zone, beg your pardon. Stasiak, Keith, a couple of dribbles. Top to Holland. Left side to Malco. Malco in the corner to Murphy. Murphy drives the baseline. Lob pass is tipped away right into the hands of Bowman for Southwood. And the Lady Knights coming to our right. Bowman at the elbow. Throws up a shot. It's good. And timeout, Southwood. It'll be a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
It's all in the name, and at All About Pets, it really is all about pets. All About Pets Downtown Rochester is your locally owned pet store that caters to you and your pet. They work hard to bring the very best in pet supplies to our area. Choose from premium pet foods, pet healthcare supplies, toys and treats, small animal food, pet accessories, fish and aquarium supplies. That's All About Pets, one block north of the courthouse on Main Street in Rochester. Their only business is to enhance the happiness of your pet. And we're all
Basketball, WROI. 1:47 to play in the first half. Southwood up 23-19, which is the biggest lead of the game by either squad of four. And after the Southwood timeout, Rochester will have the basketball going to our left. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. It has been physical, it has been loud, but it hasn't been a lot of points in the first half. Murphy around the defense of Holland. In the corner to State, to Malco. And Becky travels before the pass.
Both teams really struggling to find openings for shots and then having trouble knocking them down when they do find them.
And then Stoffer's out of the game, but yet so is B, and both battle with two fouls. Elliott will go coast to coast. Her jumper over Murphy is no good, but Murph just picked up a foul. That's going to send a freshman, Brooke Elliott, to the line to shoot two.
Murph will pick up her first.
Carly Murphy at the line shooting two for Southwood.
Alicia Phillips is in the game for Southwood, a 5'3 junior. Alexa Garrison will come back in after the first free throw by Elliott. First one for the freshman is good. Well, one more. So Garrison in, and Murphy will sit with one personal foul.
Alexa Garrison.
24-19, Southwood on top, and Elliott at the line to shoot one more for her Lady Knight. Elliott ready. The freshman fires a second one. No good. And Stasiak with the rebound. Nope. Taken away by Friend. And Friend loses it out of bounds.
Friend just beat Stasiak to the corner. Beat her to the ball. I think the Lady Zebras are a little bit
tired.
Well, mentally unfocused, maybe. Mentally tired.
Yeah, it could
and
be.
And I think that's causing them to be a step slow.
Wow. A minute 20 to play first half. 24-19, Southwood. Pass down low to Garrison. She loses the basketball. Abbott comes out of there with it. To Holland for three. Left wing. Too long. Abbott with the rebound. Kicks it out to Holland. X in the paint. Outside to Malco. Becky feeds down no good. The Garrison, her jumper over Elliott's no good. Ball tipped out of bounds. Last touch by Southwood. It'll stay with Rochester.
And the reason I say that is because I think if we get into a running match up and down the floor, I think the Lady Zebras can keep with the Lady Knights. I just think it's the mental approach where they're not thinking quick enough for the reaction time.
X out to Malco. 55 seconds to play first half. Rochester down 24-19. Holland top of the key. Now right elbow. Kicks it out to Malco. She'll fire a rare three. It's off the mark. No good. Stasiak with the rebound on the weak side. Out to Malco. Becky in the paint. Between her legs dribble. Floater on the way. And before the shot, we're going to have a foul on Southwood, which will send Rochester to the line to shoot two.
That'll be Friends first.
So Becky Malco will go to the line to shoot two for the Lady Zebras. 38.6 seconds to play in the first half. Becky Malco with two. First one for the sophomore on the way. Wow. And it goes through. She stands up between the backboard and the back iron, and it kind of rolls through. I guess whatever at this point works, right?
Right. It's just about stuck on the back iron.
One more coming from Malco. Looking to cut this lead to three. The segment is no good. And the ball tipped out of bounds. The Southwood had three girls around the basketball fighting for it. It goes out. Rochester's going to get it back down by four with 38 seconds to play in the first half. Holland will trigger it in over the defense to Malco. Becky drives it left. Down low to Abbott. Abbott foul on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two. Down peg. It'll be two.
And the call.
Bailey Abbott. Again, Bailey's first game, a 5'8 junior. Will go to the line to shoot two. With Rochester down by four with 32.5 seconds to play in the first half. Abbott, left-handed free throw on the way is good. She'll have one more. Murphy will come back into the game for Abbott if she makes this free throw.
This is the 10th free throw in this quarter for the Lady Zebras.
In the quarter?
In the quarter. They've only got two field goals.
Wow. Bailey's second one. Good again. 24-22. Murphy back in. Abbott will sit out. 32.5 seconds to play in the first half. Full court press by Rochester. Elliott. Gets it in, and she travels. Now we're going to have a tie-up, and it's going to go Southwood. I think she traveled first.
I think you're right.
Southwood. Phillips is a 5'3 junior, and obviously after seeing that, you want her to have the basketball if you're Rochester. Elliott will let you get it in around Murphy in the full court press. 30 seconds to play first half. Oh, the top of the defense to Peg. Peg to wide open Harnish. Harnish in the paint has a stripped away by Rochester Stasiak. Now Malco runs. Malco ahead to Holland. Right-handed layup is good. And we're tied at 24. Timeout Southwood with 17.5 seconds to play in the first half of the 60. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball. 92.1 WROI.
We've got credit. Come and get it. Mike Anderson, Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram of Rochester, has your back when it comes to financing a car. We finance almost everyone. Credit challenged? Come and get it. Bad credit or no credit? Come and get it. Why are we so sure we can finance you? Mike Anderson owns the finance company. There's no middleman. Let Mike Anderson give you the fresh start you deserve today. And right now, during the Big Finish 2013, is your best chance. Choose from hundreds of new and certified pre-owned cars at Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, all prepared to sell out. Like a new 2014 Dodge Dart SE for only $19,303. Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is waiting to finance your next car at 1702 Main Street in Rochester or at MikeAnderson.com. Remember, we've got credit. Come and get it at Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. To qualified buyers with approved credit, see dealer for details.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
17.5 seconds to play in the first half. We're tied at 24. Southwood down to three timeouts for the rest of the game. Rochester the full court press. Elliott gets it in to Heath.
Bowman and Stauffer back in for Lady Knights for the last 17 seconds.
Heath drives it right with 10. Now to Harnish, top of the key with 8. Holds to Elliott. With 6.
Looking for Bauman on the baseline. Stauffer underneath.
Stauffer with 3. Her jumper with 2 is no good. And the ball tipped out of bounds. But we are at halftime. At halftime, we're tied at 24. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Your telephone is your lifeline. Lifeline is a federal benefit that makes monthly telephone service more affordable for eligible low-income households.
So the Lady Zebras will start the second half with the basketball as Carly Murphy will look to get it in for the Lady Zebras. Lady Knights back in their 2-3 zone with Stouffer in the middle.
Offensive rebounds, just offensive rebounds in that first half. Mm-hmm. Southwood had 10.
Wow. Yeah, that tells a big tale why this game is as tight as it is.
10 second and third opportunities.
Right.
Tied at 24, Rochester gets the basketball going to our right. 2-3 zone by the Southwood Lady Knights. Holland, left wing to Malco, gives him the baseline to Stasiak. Keaton travels.
Yep. And Pollock working the free throw line and not the baseline.
Hey, hold up.
So I think we're going to have a clock situation. 24 seconds. Well, no. I think we've got more than 7 seconds gone. The clock has stopped.
Yeah, that's why they stopped the game right away. And reset it.
There we go. 7.5 to play in the third quarter. 24-24. And after the Rochester turnover, Southwood will have the basketball. And here's something that we haven't seen yet this year. Rochester, early on in the third, is going to step up into a full-court
pressure. We're going to see if we can't ratchet up the flow of the ball game here.
And now the referee is giving Kathy Easterday all sorts of grief for running the clock, calling an operator error. You know, I've seen that happen a lot here at
Rochester. Operator error?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
So Southwood breaks the press easily as Stouffer gives to Heath, who runs all the way to the basket, throws it, but layup is good. That was an easy time down the floor for Southwood, as that now lead by two at 26-24. Holland against the 2-3 zone. Outside to Malco. Becky works to the middle of the floor, to Holland right side, back to Malco on the elbow. Now in the paint, feeds down low to Pollock. V, jumper, good, and we're tied at 26. Full court press by Rochester again. Heath gets it from Stouffer. Heath crosses the timeline, middle of the floor, works to the left side, gives a Stouffer at the elbow. She stands with the ball above her head. Now on the right baseline to Elliott. She drives the baseline. Now to Heath to the left side. Heath gives to a cutting Bowman. Her shot's short, and Malco with the rebound. Rochester runs. We're tied at 26.
I think that's the first one and done for the Lady Knights.
Just getting ready to say that. To Holland, left side to Murph. Murph looking down low to Stasiak. Cross court to Malco. Down low to B. Backs her way in against a double team. Loses the basketball, but gets it to Malco. Right side, now to Holland, top of the key. Three on the way for Rochester's off the mark. Stasiak, the rebound, the putback is good.
Nice job by Keaton Stasiak, establishing position down low and then finishing it with the layup.
28-26, Rochester. Bowman against Malco. Works to the paint. Throws up a baby hook. It's short. B. Pollock flat-footed, grabs the board. Gives the head to Murphy. Rochester up by two. Murphy, right side of the floor, hesitates, accelerates. 10-footer right side is short. Stasiak rebound. The putback is no good.
And
Stouffer with a rebound.
Fell away.
And now Holland steals the basketball. Her shot partially blocked by Stouffer. Knocked out of bounds by Stouffer. Rochester can keep possession.
And Holland kind of lost her footing when she went up for that shot. And then, consequently, he came up on the bottom side of the rim.
Stasiak did that as well.
Yeah.
Which, in fact, helped because it kept the Stouffer off her hip trying to block the shot.
Well, she'll definitely change or alter some shots, that's for sure.
Well, that's what 6'2 does when you're playing against 5'4. Holland to Dalek. And now we're going to have a foul on the reach in by Bowman.
Bowman, that's her third.
5:44 to play. Third quarter, Rochester up 28-26. It's been a tough battle the first two quarters and 2 minutes. Holland, Murphy. Murphy fakes a three, drives into the paint. Wraparound pass is kicked away by Harnish.
It was advised as there were four Lady Knights between Murphy and Pollock.
Now Bowman has it. Bowman to Harnish for three in the lead. Short, good rebound by Pollock. And we're going to have an over-the-back call on Heath. And Rochester going to get it back.
That'll be Heath's third.
5:25 to play in the third, 28-26. Holland, 2-3 zone by the Southwood Knights to Malco, to Murphy. Murphy in the right wing to Holland in the right corner. X couple of dribbles inside the arc. Back to make that Murphy on the right wing. High on the right side is Murph. Couple of dribbles to the middle of the floor and out of Malco. Becky out to Holland. Drives around the defense. Cut off by Stauffer. Out to Malco. Top the key. Goes left. Now goes right. Pulls up jumper over Stauffer. No good. Pop back by Pollock. It's no good. Stauffer the board.
That's the one we needed there, was by Pollock on the opposite wing.
Now Bowman down the floor. Gives to Stauffer. 10-footer in the paint is short. Pollock with the rebound. Pollock now out to Malco. Rochester runs up by two, going to our right. Malco out to Holland. Fakes the three. Drives it to the elbow. Out to Murph. Murphy. One dribble. Bounce pass to the near side to Holland. Looking for Pollock. Now feeds her against Stauffer. Pollock out to Murphy. Fakes the three. In the paint. Wrap around pass to Stasiak. She's fouled on the shot. Stauffer's going to pick up a foul. That's going to send Keaton to the line to shoot two.
Stauffer picks up her third. So three of the starters for the Lady Knights. Bowman, Stauffer, and Heath, yeah, all with three.
More importantly, Stauffer and Bowman.
Mm-hmm.
That's where all the points are at.
Yeah, you're right.
Stasiak at the lane. Says the line to shoot two free throws. Keaton ready. First one on the way is good. And Rochester matches their biggest lead of the night of three. It's 29-26. One more coming for the sophomore with 4:26 to play in the third. Stasiak, second one. Good again. Rochester up 30-26. A little four-court pressure for Rochester. Stauffer gives to Heath across the timeline right. Now drives it left. Switches directions, top of the key to Harnish. To Stauffer at the free throw line. Gives him the baseline to Elliott. Elliott against the double team. Her shot's partially blocked. Murphy grabs the board and rips it away from Bowman. And Rochester runs.
I have a feeling that maybe Coach Stasiak talked about rebounding at halftime.
I would hope so.
They look like they're a little more determined.
Holland bounce pass top of the key to Malco. Becky chest pass to Murphy. Down low to Pollock. B in the lane. Over Stauffer. Jumper's good. Rochester up 32-26. Rochester up by six. Heath quickly up the floor for Southwood. To Harnish, high on the right side. Harnish hands the ball above her head to Stauffer. Stauffer gives it back door to Bowman. She loses it right in the hands of Elliott. Her shot's no good, but a foul coming on Rochester. And that's going to send Brooke Elliott to the line to shoot two for the Southwood Lady Knights. Stauffer led Bowman perfectly on that backdoor pass, but Bowman couldn't control the pass. It almost went out of bounds. She saved it right in the hands of Bowman, who was fouled on the shot.
Stasiak will pick up her first.
And the first free throw by Elliott's no good. She'll have one more. 32-26 Rochester. 3:37 to play in the third quarter. Brooke Elliott, the 5'7 freshman, with one more for Southwood. Second one on the way is good this time. 32-27. Rochester, the basketball and the lead going to our right. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. We've seen a tight game throughout here at Rochester. Holland picks up her dribble. Bounce pass top of the key to Murph. Back to Holland, right side. Looking for Pollock. Can't find her. Couple of dribbles back to Murph. Swings it quickly to Malco. Pull up 10-footer. Left baseline is too hard. And the rebound to Southwood. Heath with the basketball and runs for the Knights. And she loses her footing. Picks up the basketball. And we're going to have a timeout by Southwood. And it will be A 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Come check out the amazing deals at the Winning Edge in Rochester. You'll find really huge savings this holiday season. They offer in-store specials, and the December special is 30% off all baseball and softball bats and gloves. They have the equipment, backpacks, and duffels for your favorite sport or gift-giving need. They carry major apparel brands including Under Armour, Russell, Adidas, and so many more. So visit their webpage, thewinedge.com, or their Facebook page. Call 574-223-6090. Quality products, unique customizing options, and friendly service from the Winning Edge, Raw Place Drive in Rochester.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
3:12 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 32-27. After the Southwood timeout, they'll have the basketball on the far side right in front of the Rochester student section. Bowman looks to get it in, does so around the defense to Heath. And Heath will cross the timeline. Bailey Abbott will come back into the next opportunity. Heath drives it left, gives him the baseline to Elliott. Elliott at the elbow, out to Harnish. Three from the left wing. Good! Next up, the Rochester lead to two.
Second three of the game for Harnish.
Good, well-timed game, big shot for Harnish.
Right, Stasiak way too hard off the backboard.
She was expecting some contact, didn't get it. And now Southwood will go to the basket. Shot no good. Stauffer shot no good. Holland comes out of there with it. Rochester runs. Left side of the floor is Holland. X now has it stolen by Harnish. Harnish runs for Southwood. Rochester by two. Harnish carries the ball. No call. Heath, that is the rebound. And the basket is good.
Tied back up.
Yep, 32-32. Helter Skelter right now at Rochester has been that way for the entire first half, and now it is in there in the third quarter. Murphy on the right baseline. Draws the contact. No foul. And her shot's picked up by Harnish, and Southwood goes to our left. We're tied at 32, 2 minutes to play in the third quarter. Harnish feeds down low to Stauffer against Pollock, backs her way in, and her pass and her ball is ripped away by Stasiak. Yep. Probably could have been a charge. No charge called, and Stasiak rips it away for a steal to Malco. Becky, caught by the double team, wraparound pass to B. Pollock shot no good, Stauffer the board. And now Heath runs to our left for Southwood. A minute 35 to play, third quarter. Harnish fakes the three, gives back to Heath. We're tied at 32. Heath in the lane. Tier drops off the window is good.
That's her sixth point here in the third quarter.
And now Southwood back up at 34 to 32. Malco works against the 2-3 zone. Holland for three, right side. Nope. And the long rebound to Pollock. B back to Holland. X to Malco to Murphy. Passes up a three, gives him out, and Malco travels. Pollock makes that Abbott coming back into the game. Garrison back into the game. Malco and Holland.
Zebras, number 20.
Sit for Rochester.
And number 40, Alexa Garrison.
Going to put Stasiak on the basketball, and Murphy, I would assume.
Murphy will be the guard,
point,
yeah. 34-32, Southwood on top, the minute to play in the third quarter. Pass goes to Harnish. Quickly to Houlihan, back to Harnish. Step back three for Southwood. Nope, too hard. Pollock with the board. B rips it and gives to Stasiak. Keaton now bounce pass to Murphy, and she'll bring it up with 47 seconds to play in the third quarter. Southwood by two.
Murph's going to look for the last shot.
Yep. Murph just dribbles near the timeline. Now Bowman comes down to apply some pressure. She backs it out and will fall back in that 2-3 zone with 30 seconds to play in the third quarter. Rochester down by two. Murphy stands basically right in front of the Rochester bench and dribbles. Murphy dribbles. Looks for Coach Stasiak for
Everybody's content to just let this clock run down.
Under 20 to play, and now Coach Stasiak does go. Under 20 to play in the third. Murphy picks up her dribble. Bounce pass top of the key to Stasiak with 13, and she travels. 13.3 to play in the third. Southwood going to get it back, up by two. 34-32, full court press by Rochester. Bowman looks to get it in around Abbott. Right in front of the Rochester bench. Bowman, bounce pass into Heath. Heath across the timeline with 10. Heath middle of the floor with 8. Right wing now, wraparound pass down low to Houlihan with 5. Now to Elliott with 3. Shot's no good. Rebound to Pollock. Murphy. They cannot get a shot off as the third quarter comes to an end. After three, Southwood leads 34-32. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Local people making a big difference when it comes to insurance needs. Insurance does not have to be complicated. That's why Smith, Sawyer, and Smith Insurance are your local trusted choice agent. They have access to multiple insurance carriers that offer competitive pricing and individual coverage. Call 574-223-2166 or stop by their downtown location at 124 East 8th Street, Rochester, or visit their website at www.smithsawyerins.com. Smith Sawyer Smith Insurance, protecting individuals and families since 1932.
Get smooth one coat coverage and a lifetime warranty when you buy paint at Innard's True Value Hardware Store, 1619 Main, Rochester. Choose Easy Care Ultra Premium Interior Latex Paint with excellent one coat coverage and easy cleanup, or Weatherall Ultra Premium Exterior Latex Paint with stain resistance and great coverage, and get great savings. Find everything you need for your paint projects plus expert local advice at Innard's True Value Hardware Store, Monday through Friday, 7 to 7, Saturday, 7 to 6, Sunday, 9 to 5. Innard's True Value. Start right. Start here.
We're back at Rochester High School for the fourth and final quarter. The Southwood Lady Knights lead 34-32, and they will start with the basketball. Malco and Holland back into the game. Elliott will look to get it in around Stasiak. Does so to Heath.
Heath, Stouffer, and Bowman on the floor for the Lady Knights, each with 3 fouls.
Yeah. Keith is good. Stoper, I beg your pardon, has been a big difference in this game, both offensively and defense. She has altered so many shots. Heath throws up a shot of the glass. It's good.
Well, and Heath now with 8 points for the Lady Knights. Six in the third and two right there.
Haley Heath, a 5'4 junior. We'll see her again next year. We'll see a lot of these girls next year, including Stomper. 36-32. Southwood on top. Murphy in the right corner on the baseline. Now to the left wing to Holland. Holland, a couple of dribbles back to Malco on the right side. 2-3 zone by Southwood. Inside the three-point line is Malco. She throws it away. Ball loose. Still loose. And Southwood traveled with no call. Now Bowman has it. And Bowman pushed Houlihan to the floor and traveled. But Rochester makes that Southwood keeps possession. Elliott gets away with a forearm to the chest. She throws up a shot. No good. And the rebound is to Beth Malco. Becky runs. Rochester down by four. Malco, middle of the floor, in the paint, down low to Stasiak. Her jumper's good. 36-34, Southwood lead cut to two. When you can outrun Stomper, that's exactly what happens. You get great looks in the paint.
Right. It opens up quite a little bit when you take 6-2 out of the middle.
Stomper at the elbow, down low to wide open Elliott. And she's fouled on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
Stasiak will pick up her second.
Six and a half to play in the game. Southwood leads 36-34. And going to the line will be Brooke Elliott, the 5'7 freshman for Southwood, with two freebies.
He's 2 of 4 from the line tonight.
First one is good. And with that free throw, the lead is extended to three. One more coming. 37-34 Southwood. One more coming for Elliott. Right-handed free throw is good again. 38-34. Southwood back up by four with, again, six and a half to play in the basketball game. Murphy on the wing looking for Pollock on the block. One dribble. Back outside to Malco. Left side to Holland. Eck throws up a shot in the lane. It goes with a lot of contact. No foul, but it cuts the lead to two.
Her first point since halftime.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Ahead to Bowman to a cutting Stomper. Stomper over Pollock is good.
That's Stomper's first points in the half.
40-36. Calling out to Murphy. Three on the way, right wing. No good. And we're going to push off, I believe, on Stasiak, and it's going to go back to the Lady Knights.
Number
40-36 Southwood. Rochester now to full court press with 5:58 to play in the game.
Stasiak picks up her third.
Baseball pass inbounds. It's stolen by Murphy. Murph in the paint. Leaner on the way. Is no good, but a foul coming on Southwood, and Murph will go to the line to shoot two.
Foul's coming against Heath. That's her fourth.
Shooting two. Fourth.
And actually, that's a good thing for Rochester. She's been basically, she's kept Southwood on her back and did this roll.
8 points in the second half.
Murph's free throw is good as it rattles around and falls through. So one more. Looking to cut this lead to two with this freebie with 5:55 to play in the fourth quarter. Murphy's second one good again as it rattles in. 40-38 Southwood.
I don't think she felt that confident about that shot.
I think you're right. She started chasing it before it got there, really. Bowman ahead to Elliott. And we're going to have a travel. And Elliott, Rochester going to get it back.
Great job by Carly Murphy getting down in front of Elliott, disrupting her as she turned to dribble with the basketball.
Yeah. 5:50 to play in the game. Rochester with an opportunity to tie or to take the lead on this possession. Holland top of the key against the man-to-man defense. And Heath. Holland out to Murphy. Three in the way. Right wing. In and out. No good. Stomper the rebound. Good look. Just couldn't get her to go. Heath around the defense. Gets a great pick from Houlihan. Now Houlihan, the stopper at the free throw line. Outside to Heath. Three in the way. Left wing. It's good. That's a huge shot for Haley Heath. And it's 43-38 Southwood. Holland, uncontested the basket. She throws one in for two.
Heath with 11 now after that three-pointer.
43-40, Southwood. Heath dribbles right, pulls it back outside. We'll set up the offense for Southwood. Now down low, is taken away by Pollock. B gives to Murphy. Nice job by B getting around Stomper to intercept that pass. Murphy outside to Holland. Three-point lead for Southwood. Holland, right wing to Malco with 4:45 to play in the game. 43-40. Three on the way for Holland is no good. Stasiak with the rebound. Her put back in the paint is off the window. No good. Stopper the rebound. And she gives off to Heath. Southwood runs up by three. Bowman against Malco. Cut off on the baseline. Outside to a wide open Heath for three. Good again. Rochester will take a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Rochester Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
As long as the kids keep making the traveling team and the new restaurant across town doesn't deliver, you're going to be driving. So it's a smart choice to join new BP Driver Rewards. You receive an instant 10 cents per gallon reward just for signing up. With every second fill up of quality BP gasoline, you keep earning and saving 5 cents per gallon. Pick up a BP Driver Rewards brochure at your local BP to join now. Up to 20 gallons, terms and conditions apply. See bpdriverrewards.com for details.
A new dual car wash combining both soft cloth and high pressure technology for a really clean car is coming to the Good to Go Car Wash. Purchase your wash at either Good to Go locations and save up to 20 cents per gallon on your gas purchase. Give it a try beginning November 1st.
Dean Foods have been supplying dairy products to America's table since 1925. They're proud to bring you outstanding dairy products that promote a healthy living for you and your family. Everyone needs calcium, and dairy products are the purest way to get your daily requirements. When shopping, load up on the perfect foods. Dairy products from Dean Foods, Rochester. Dean Foods, created by nature, delivered by Dean.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
4:20 to play in the game. Southwood now up after another three-point bomb by Heath, 46-40.
She's got 14 in the second half.
Yeah, she's single-handedly kept Southwood not only in this game, but with the most lead most of the second half.
Right.
Holland in the lane, floater off the glass, no good. The putback by Abbott is no good. The ball being tipped around. Rochester comes out of there with it. Abbott against Stopper, no good. Abbott gets the rebound. Ball loose. Stasiak shot, good, the foul.
Nice job by Keith Stasiak, just hanging around waiting for an opportunity to get her hands on the basketball. And a great job by Bailey Abbott as she continues to battle inside against the much bigger Stopper.
So Keaton at the line to shoot one, looking to cut this lead to three. And that foul was on Brooke Elliott, her second.
Mm-hmm.
Keaton ready. Fires a free throw. It's no good. And the rebound to Bailey Abbott. Abbott kicks it out to Stasiak. To Malco. Back to to Bailey. Back to Malco. Top of the key to Holland. Four-point lead for Southwood. Malco high on the right side against the 2-3 zone. To Holland, left wing in the corner to Stasiak. Keaton, one dribble, out to Holland. X drives, shot over, Stopper is good. Lead is cut to two at 46-44. Heath runs to our left, up by two. To Houlihan, backs her way in, throws it out to Heath, fakes the three. Now gives outside to Houlihan, to Stopper at the elbow. In the corner to Elliott. Drives around Stasiak, and Elliott's fouled on this drive, and she'll go, it'll be out of bounds to Southwood at 3:15 to play in the basketball game, and I believe Keaton just picked up foul number four.
She did. So Keaton and Heath for the Lady Knights, both with four fouls.
3:15 to play in the game. Southwood up 46-44. Heath will look to get it in. Boy, she better hurry. She's trying to get it in. She's got to hurry, and just does before the five-second count to Bowman. Bowman around the defense, loses the handle. Keaton Stasiak picks it up, gives it to Pollock. Down to Malco. 3 minutes to play in the game. Rochester down by two. Malco, cross court left to Holland. Back to Malco, right wing. Malco inside the three-point line, loses the handle, gives to Stasiak. Keaton, one dribble, back to Malco, left side to Holland. Lob pass to Abbott. Bailey is going to be tied up. It's going to stay with Rochester.
She's got to shoot. She's trying to look around Stauffer for Pollock on the opposite block, and the Lady Knights have that paint packed in pretty good. She just needs to turn and shoot over the top.
With Southwood, number three, Emily.
Harnish back in. Elliott to sit for Southwood. 2:47 to play in the game. Southwood up by two at 46-44. Murphy back into the game, and Stasiak with four fouls will come out.
You've got to watch the corner.
Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. X looking over the top to Pollock. V at the free throw line, out to Murphy. Murph high on the left side, and we'll reset at the top of the key. Now to Malco high on the right wing. Bounce pass left side to Holland. 2.5 to play in the game. To Malco right side. Drives, pulls it back outside.
you got to be careful with those passes.
Ball is loose.
To the top.
Picked up by Heath, and Malcolm picks up a foul for the reach-in. Yeah, it's tough to, as long as Southwood is, tough to get it over the top of the defense.
And the Lady Zebras have a bad habit of pulling that open from baseline to baseline and thinking they can throw across the top of that zone. We've seen it more than one time throughout the season.
Heath, who's had a big second half, drives around the pick, throws up a shot over Holland. It's no good. Pog on the board. Rochester down by two with 2:10 to play in the game. Holland right side, bounce pass to Murphy, drives the right baseline, stops and travels. Stasiak back in. And who's coming out? Bailey Abbott's coming out.
Number 25, Brooke Elliott.
Southwood has two timeouts, Rochester with three, I think. 2:10 to play in the game. Southwood up 46-44. Heath with the basketball. Works against Holland in the backcourt. Works to the right wing. Still with the dribble. Now to the middle of the floor. Picks up her dribble over the defense to Bowman. Now to Harnish. Down low to Stopper. Ball tipped out of bounds. Last touch by Rochester. Will stay with Southwood. Nice job by, I believe it was Malco and also Stasiak, fronting and playing behind Stopper. And Phil is able to get a hand on the pass. Bowman, top of the key. Bowman works to the right elbow. Out to Elliott. Fakes the shot, drives the baseline. She is cut off. No foul, a lot of contact. The ball is knocked out of bounds by Pollock. It'll stay with Southwood. A minute 47 to play in the game. Again, the Lady Knights up 46-44. Bowman gets the inbound pass. Picks up her dribble, gives it to Elliott at the free throw line. Jumper is good for the freshman. Southwood back up by four. 90 seconds to play in the game. Malco through the center circle, 2-3 zone. Holland for three, right wing. In and out, no good. And the rebound to Stasiak. Keaton over Stopper, and we're going to have a foul on Stopper. That's going to send Stasiak to the line to shoot two.
Stopper will pick up her four.
I beg your pardon.
Emily Harnish, her first.
Shooting two. That's better for Southwood.
Yeah, it is.
I didn't think she was in the area.
I didn't know that she was there either.
So Stasiak at the line to shoot two. Rochester down by four. 1:26 to play in the game. Heaton's free throw is too hard off the back of the iron, so I have one more. So Abbott back in, and Murphy to sit.
24, Bailey Abbott.
Heaton Stasiak with one free throw. Now looking to cut this lead to three. Late in the ball game here at Rochester. First conference game of the season for both Southwood and the Lady Zebras. Second one for Stasiak is good this time. And now Coach Stasiak will use a 30. You're listening to Rochester Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Take the leap into online bill pay with First Federal Savings Bank. Online bill pay is the easier, faster, and safer way to pay all your bills. Hop into the convenience of paying all your bills from one secure website and gain greater control over both your time and your finances. With First Federal's online bill pay, you get control of being able to change, edit, or stop pending payments. You'll have the convenience of paying anyone who you would normally pay by check, and you can manage all of your payments from one location. Log in to your online banking account at www.firstfederalbanking.com and jump in today. First Federal Savings Bank, 301 East 9th Street, Rochester, and 814 North US 35 in Winnemac, FDIC insured, equal housing lender.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
A minute 26 to play in the game. Southwood up 48-45, and Rochester will be in a full-court press. Southwood will look to get it in around that. Elliott. Look to get it in around Malco. Baseball pass down the floor. Tipped away by Bailey Abbott. Out of bounds. Man, they have missed that athleticism.
Yeah. Well, Bowman had her defender beat by 5 yards, but the pass was short.
Heath will trigger it in for Southwood. Underneath the basket, baseline right. Bounce pass in is knocked out of bounds by Rochester with a minute 23 to play in the game. Again, Southwood up 48-45. Heath again will trigger it in. Heath, baseball pass in. The Rochester side of the timeline to Harnish. Harnish pushes off, no call. She gets it across the timeline. Wide open Elliott, and she loses it. And Malco picks it up.
This plane dropped it.
Malco, left side of the floor, will pull it out and run some offense to Holland. Holland back to Malco. Left side to Stasiak. Keaton, baseline. Cut off by Stauffer. Out to Malco to Holland. Three for the tie. Right wing is good.
Alexa Holland again with the big three-pointer.
Baseball pass down the floor to Bowman. Bowman, left-handed layup is no good. Stasiak with the rebound with 50 seconds. Now fouled Harnish. Stasiak will... It'll be Rochester basketball out of bounds with 50.6 seconds to play in the basketball game. And I believe, Rochester going to shoot free throws. Oh, beg your pardon.
Yep, Harnish is going to pick up her second on the reach in on the rebound.
Another big shot by the sophomore, Lexa Holland. This time to tie the game at 48. And Keaton Stasiak with one of the bonus for the Zebras.
Those were her 17th point on that big three-pointer.
Coach Stasiak / dad is about ready to puke.
Lock out, Ben.
Stasiak has one of the bonus first one. The sophomore is good as it rattles home. Rochester up 49-48 with 50.6 to play in the battle game. Keaton with one more. Second one for the sophomore. Good again. And now Coach Stasiak will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
If you're stuck with high monthly car payments and think it's the best you can do, think again. By refinancing your car loan with State Farm Bank, you may save on your monthly payments and have more money to spend on other things. Call State Farm agent Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017 for more information. Jeff will help you see how much you could save by refinancing with State Farm Bank. That's Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017. State Farm Bank. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Is your water softener on the job protecting you from higher energy bills, dingy laundry, and spotted dishes? A water softener can save you as much as 20% of your energy bill, but only if your water softener has been set properly for hardness and your water use. Water stores and home improvement stores don't size properly because they don't have enough choices. For more choices, Home Salt delivery to any brand softener and a 30-day satisfaction guarantee, call Culligan of Fulton County, 574-223-2020. Culligan, better water, pure and simple.
Zebra basketball, WROI.
50.6 seconds to play in regulation. Rochester up 50-48. A big three and two freebies by Keaton Stasiak. Well, it's a big three by Holland and a big two free throws by Stasiak to put the Rochester Zebras up.
You're right. Foul trouble, Stasiak for the Lady Zebras with three for the Lady Knights. Bowman with three, Keith with four, and Stauffer with three.
Southwood gets the basketball in against the full court press. Harnish gives to Bowman with 45. Bowman being chased by Abbott. And Bowman leads across the timeline.
10 points below her average tonight.
Yeah, that's what scares me. Look out for finding 21 of the four. Stauffer. And now we're going to have a Southwood timeout with 35.9 to play in the game at the 60. We'll take a 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Got credit. Come and get it. Mike Anderson, Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram of Rochester has your back when it comes to financing a car. We finance almost everyone. Credit challenged? Come and get it. Bad credit or no credit? Come and get it. Why are we so sure we can finance you? Mike Anderson owns the finance company. There's no middleman. Let Mike Anderson give you the fresh start you deserve today. And right now, during the Big Finish 2013, is your best chance. Choose from hundreds of new and certified pre-owned cars at Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, all prepared to sell out. Like a new 2014 Dodge Dart SE for only $19,303. Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is waiting to finance your next car at 1702 Main Street in Rochester or at MikeAnderson.com. Remember, we've got credit. Come and get it at Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. To qualified buyers with approved credit, see dealer for details.
Zebra basketball, WROI.
Back at Rochester High School, 34 makes that 35.9 seconds to play in the game. Rochester up 50-48. Both teams down to just one timeout. The possession arrow is to Southwood. It'll be Southwood basketball underneath their own basket baseline left as Heath will look to get it in around Stasiak.
Looking for Stauffer.
Lobs it into Stauffer. You got it. Stauffer down low to Elliott. Elliott against Stasiak. Turn around. Jumper's going to retire at 50. 28 seconds of play in the game. Holland with the basketball. One timeout left apiece. Holland across the timeline with 22. And now Coach Stasiak will use their final timeout of the game at the 60. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
You make a sound investment when you choose a New Holland T9 Series four-wheel drive tractor from New Holland Rochester. You get big engine and hydraulic power and up to 10% cost savings thanks to cutting-edge Echo Blue SCR engine technology. It saves you money on fuel, and ground speed management adjusts both engine and transmission speeds for better field performance and economy. Stop by New Holland Rochester and see what New Holland T9 Series four-wheel drive tractors can do for your operation. New Holland Rochester, Highway 25 South. And we're all
about pets. It's all in the name, and at All About Pets, it really is all about pets. All About Pets, downtown Rochester, is your locally owned pet store that caters to you and your pet. They work hard to bring the very best in pet supplies to our area. Choose from premium pet foods, pet health care supplies, toys and treats, small animal food, pet accessories, fish and aquarium supplies. That's All About Pets, one block north of the courthouse on Main Street in Rochester. Their only business is to enhance the happiness of your pet. And we're all
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
21.4 to play in regulation. We're tied at 50. Rochester's out of timeout. Southwood has won. The possession arrow is to Southwood. It'll be Rochester basketball right in front of the scorer's table. Brad Thomas, I'm David Mossman. Another thriller here for the Rochester Lady Zebras. Brad, you and I were talking off the air. This cannot go to overtime.
No, I don't think Rochester has anything left in them.
Holland has it in the center circle with 19. Man-to-man defense. Gets a pick from B. Down goes left with 14. Holland dribbles around to the top of the key with 12. Gives off to Malco with 10. Malco drives it left with 8. Loses the handle. Picks it up to Murphy with 4. Murphy has it lost. She gets it back. Throws up a shot. No good. Stop with the rebound. It's going to overtime. We're going to overtime. Tied at 50. You're listening to Ladies Ear Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Your telephone is your lifeline. Lifeline is a federal benefit that makes monthly telephone service more affordable for eligible, low-income households. A subscriber that meets criteria as established by the Indiana Utility Regulatory Commission and lives within the Rochester Telephone Company service area must be a participant in one of the following programs to qualify for the Lifeline benefit: Medicaid, food stamps, supplementary security income, federal public housing assistance, low-income home energy program, temporary assistance to needy families, national school lunch free program, and income-based federal eligibility. Only one Lifeline benefit per household is allowed. For more information or to see if you qualify for Lifeline assistance, please call Rochester Telephone Company at 223-2191.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Overtime we go here at Rochester High School. We're tied at 50, and probably, luckily, we're tied at 50. I mean, worst case scenario, we went to overtime, but, man, as many opportunities as Southwood has had this entire basketball game at point-blank range and getting very few of them to fall. And the other thing that kind of worries me a little bit for Rochester is their leading scorer, Amy Bowman, for Southwood, has not had a point this half and has been very quiet.
She's
with
got 8 points, and they were all in the second quarter. So
Haley Heath.
Haley Heath, she's got 14 all in the second half.
So it'll be Stauffer and Pollock to jump, and Bowman gets the tip. Drives it right at the elbow, gives him the baseline to Elliott, who's had a big basketball game. Out to Harnish. Her step back long two is good. Southwood back up 52-50. Malco works it right, drives it right in the paint, down low to Stasiak. Stasiak, leaner, no good. A foul coming on Harsh, and that'll be make that Harnish. That'll be her third. And Keaton will go to the line to shoot two.
Southwood, number three, Emily Harnish, at the line for the Zebras.
Harnish, going to make that Stauffer, and Heath with four. So Stasiak at the line to shoot two. Keaton fires the first one. It is good as it's a little short. Hits the front of the iron a couple of times and it rolls over. Southwood by one. One more coming for Stasiak to try to tie this one up again. Keaton ready. Flies the second one. Good again. We're tied at 52. A little full-court pressure for Rochester. Heath.
8 of 11 is Stasiak in the line.
Good
in this game.
Lob pass to Stauffer. Stopper who walks, no travel, a lot of steps. The harness high on the right side, holds above her head, now drives it left. Now to Heath. Heath, couple of dribbles right side, and it's taken away by Stacey. Oh, makes that Malco and out of bounds. Becky couldn't save from going out. It'll stay with Southwood on the far side. 3:19 to play in overtime. We're tied at 52. Bowman will look to get it in. Around Malco. Bowman in the corner to Elliott. Looking for a cutting Bowman. Can't get her, now to Stopper. Stopper behind the arc. Left side to Bowman. Bowman at the free throw line. Loses her handle. Gives to Stopper. Baseline to Elliott. Shot over Murphy. Short. And the rebound to Stasiak. Keaton being contacted. A lot of contact. No foul. Now Murphy. Holland has it. Yep. Holland right wing. Hit a big three as the fourth quarter come to an end. To tie it at a 48. And now Stasiak is found on the reach in by Bowman. And that's that four on Bowman.
Yes.
And Keaton will go back to the line to shoot two. One of the bonus, I beg your pardon.
Bowman. At the line for the Zebras, shooting one and one, number 12. Keaton
Stasiak. Stasiak at the line for one of the bonus for Rochester. We're tied at 52. Keaton fires the first one. Good as it rattles around and falls through. Rochester back up, 53-52. 2:52 to play in overtime. Stasiak with one more, looking to push this lead back to two. Keaton taking a lot of time. Fires a second one, in and out, no good. Murphy grabs the rebound. Bounce pass down to Malco. Coach Stasiak is pulled out and runs some time.
Good save by Carly Murphy.
You're not kidding.
On the rebound.
Yeah, almost ready to go out of bounds.
See if the Lady Zebras can get a bucket.
Four fouls by Heath, and she's guarded Holland. Malco kicks it out to Murphy. Murphy, couple of dribbles. Now to X, top of the key. Clock rolls with 2:25 to play in overtime. Malco out to Holland. X, couple of dribbles. Gives it to Malco. Guarded against Bowman, who has four fouls. Now Holland and Southwood coach looking to foul X, and she does that. That's going to send X to the line.
And Harnish is going to pick up her fourth.
2 minutes to play in the game. Southwood basically intentionally fouls. And Southwood will use a timeout. You're listening at the 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Find great December savings at Smith Farm Store of Rochester and Plymouth. Like a 16-pack of Duracell AA batteries for just $8.99 after a $2 instant rebate with your Ace Rewards card. Pick up a Craftsman 193-piece mechanics tool set or a Craftsman 6-drawer tool chest and cabinet, your choice for only $99.99. Still searching for holiday decorations? Smith Farm Stores has 50-count spools of premium Christmas lights for just $6.99 or 150-count spools for only $17.99. Do Christmas right at the Helpful Place, Smith Farm Stores of Rochester and Plymouth.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
2:09 to play in overtime. Rochester at 53-52. And after Harnish's foul, Keaton Stasiak, going to go back to the line for one of the bonus. I think it's Keaton. But what puzzles me a bit is as many fouls as you've got on the floor right now. Now you've got four players with four fouls on the floor right now. They foul with 2 minutes to play.
Holland makes these free throws, and you don't get a bucket at the other end, you're in a definite foul situation. But you don't have any to give because all your players, somebody's going to foul out.
Yeah, you're right. So X at the line to shoot one in the bonus. Rochester up by one. First one for Holland is no good. Too harsh. We'll have one more. Rochester now with this free throw looking to push the lead back to two with 2:09 to play in overtime. Holland, second one for the sophomore. Good this time. Full court press now by the Lady Zebras. Elliott gets it into Heath. 2 minutes to play in overtime. Rochester at 54-52. Heath across the timeline against Stasiak, who has three or four. To Elliott. And Elliott travels going to the basket, so Rochester going to get back with 1:57 to play in overtime. How many Stasiak
got four?
Four, okay. Back into the game is Friend.
She's the only one for Rochester in foul trouble.
Elliott to sit. Well, I tell you what, I know it's been Bailey Abbott's first game, but I have been highly impressed with her for the first game of the year. She has brought her A game tonight. Not a lot of scoring, but man, her hustle.
What she's contributed to on defense and in rebounding has been tremendous.
I agree. Man-to-man defense by Southwood. A minute 40 to play in the overtime. Rochester at 54-52. Holland just running around, making Heath chase her, and passes off to Murphy now with 90 seconds to play in overtime. Rochester by two. Malco drives it left at the elbow, kicks it out to Holland. We're down to a minute 25 to play in overtime. Holland backs it out to the volleyball line. Now drives it left, backs it out to the timeline. Now drives it towards the bucket. Kicks it out to Murphy with a minute 15. Rochester by two at 54-52. Murphy bounce pass to Malco at the volleyball line with a minute 7. Now bounce pass to X with a minute 5.
Harnish with four fouls, guarding Holland.
Holland against Heath. Down to Malco with 55. Malco at the free throw line. Bounce pass to Murphy at 54. And Friend fouls Murphy, and Murph will go to the line to shoot two with 52.9 to play in the game.
Friend will pick up her second.
Daziak pleading for an intentional foul call. No. Murph the line to shoot two, looking to push this to a two-possession basketball game.
Technically, you're supposed to be making an attempt at the ball.
A shoulder block is attempt.
Is that what that is?
Murphy's first one for Rochester, no good. Back into the game is Elliott and Friend to sit. 52.9 seconds of play in overtime. Rochester up 54-52. Murphy with one more freebie. Murph, ready. Sets herself. Fires the second one. Good this time. Full court press for the Lady Zebras. Elliott looks to get it in. Baseball pass down the court. Picked up by Bowman against Malco. Bowman to the paint. Shot is partially blocked from behind, but Murphy going to pick up the foul. That's going to send Bowman to the line to shoot two with 49.3 to play in the overtime period. With Rochester up by three.
Murphy picks up her second. Bowman has not scored in the second half of this basketball game.
Amy Bowman, the 5'7 senior who averages 18 a game. At the line to shoot two shots. First one for the seniors, good. Back in the game is Friend. Also back in is Phillips for Southwood. Elliott and Heath, who has four personal fouls, to sit. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 49 seconds to play in overtime. Rochester by two. One more free throw coming for the senior Bowman for Southwood. Second one, good. Bounces around three or four times in the rim and falls through. Rochester by one with 45 seconds to play in overtime. Holland gets it across the timeline, being chased by two Southwood players. Gives to Murphy with 35. Murphy, wraparound pass to Malco with 32. Malco is fouled by Friend, and that's going to send Becky Malco to the line to shoot two with 29.7 to play in overtime with Rochester up by one.
Friend picks up her third. Free throws are starting to weigh big on the Lady Zebras.
Yep. Malco at the line for two for Rochester. Sophomore eyes the first one. Good as it bangs home. And Heath and Elliott back in. Friend and Phillips to sit. Rochester by two with 29.7 to play in overtime. Malco fires a second one. Good again. Rochester by three. Full court press by the Lady Zebras. Heath brings it up the floor against the double team. Cross the timeline of 25. Heath drives left side, cut off by Pollock with 22. To Stopper, jumper, the free throw line is good. Timeout Southwood. It's a 60. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Plymouth wants you to enjoy your world. And now the basketball, swimming, and wrestling are back. And college and pro football continue. There's plenty to do. So whether it's heading for the gym, holiday open houses, and getting together with friends and family, grab the refreshingly clean taste of Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, Sprite, and Sprite Zero. Make sure you have plenty of Coca-Cola products on hand, either from the store or the vending machine. Coca-Cola products go great with everything you do. It's the real thing. It's Coca-Cola. You make a
sound investment when you choose a New Holland T9 Series four-wheel drive tractor from New Holland Rochester. You get big engine and hydraulic power and up to 10% cost savings thanks to cutting-edge Echo Blue SCR engine technology. It saves you money on fuel, and ground speed management adjusts both engine and transmission speeds for better field performance and economy. Stop by New Holland Rochester and see what New Holland T9 Series four-wheel drive tractors can do for your operation. New Holland Rochester, Highway 25 South.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
19.1 seconds to play in overtime. Rochester up 57-56. Southwood now out of timeout. Rochester has one. Murphy will get the basketball in against the Southwood full court press. Murph has the basketball. Gets it into Holland. Holland around Harnish with 17, rings it up to 4, now middle of the floor with 14, pulls it out with 13, and she is fouled by Houlihan, and that's going to send X to the line for 2 with 11.9 to play in overtime, Rochester by 1.
Houlihan now with 3, so everybody with 3 or 4.
And Southwood will make almost a full line change here after the first free throw. Holland's first free throw, no good. She'll have one more.
Lady Zebras 22 of 34 now from the line.
Rochester needs this freebie. 11.9 to play in overtime. Holland with one more, looking to push this lead to 2. Second for X. Good this time. 58-56. Pass goes into Heath. Heath with 9. Heath brings it up the floor with 6. Gives to Stopper with 5. Stopper back to Heath. Now to Bowman with 2. Jumper's no good. 5 for the rebound. That'll do it. Rochester holds on in overtime to beat Southwood 58-56. Post-game thoughts after this on 92.1 WROI.